So what are you going to do about this stain?
I'm going to wash it.
This is actually something very routine. Color is
turned reddish. Why does that happen?
We have taken powdered turmeric.
All right.
And it is yellow in color.
Yellow in color.
Yeah. Why is it yellow? Due to the presence of an organic compound which is named as curcumin.
So here you have already made it. This is the stain that we accidentally get on our clothes when we are either cooking or eating also. Sometimes we drop the curry or something happens.
This is acidic. And the stain that we are getting because of the curcumin, and when we add with the soap solution, then it is a simple neutralization acid-base reaction.
That is an acid.
It's a very simple acid-base neutralization reaction.
Basic neutralization.
Soap solution.
All right.
And we have prepared here a detergent solution.
All right.
And when we have treated our turmeric with this detergent solution, it has turned reddish brown.
You've already treated it.
Yeah.
All right. And so now this is the color that you get.
Yes.
But sometimes we get a pink color. Is it because of the rubbing that this part washes off? This is what I can see here.
Fading of this red brown. Actually, this is red brown color. So when it fades, it comes to pink like that.
Because once we have rubbed it and washed it off, and then I think comes the fading part. Or even if we keep it for some time, it will fade.
Yeah.
Is that so?
Yes.
All right. So this will have the same effect whether it is detergent or soap.
Actually, detergent, they are carrying a harsher chemical than soap. That's why the fading is quite easier in detergent, not in soap.
Alright. So now, can we have this demonstration here? How it turns?
Yeah.
If we drop this detergent solution on this, shall we try that?
Yes,
but can I drop it here?
Yes,
we can do it on paper also. So, just give me this hand. Can you drop it here for me? Yes.
You can see how the color.
This is a change that is happening here.
Yes.
You can see it.
And there is a color difference. This is concentrated part. We have put detergent directly to it.
Right.
And here we have put detergent solution. So this depends.
So you can actually see the change happening in front of our eyes.
Yeah.
All right.
In this is normal turmeric solution.
All right.
In this, we have added detergent solution.
Okay.
And in this beaker, we have added pure detergent. Detergent as it is to this.
Without diluting it.
Making a solution of detergent.
We can do it here also. Wherever we do it, this is going to happen. So that is what you are
putting. That is just a
turmeric solution.
What is made over here like this?
So you can pour here also.
Yeah.
So you are putting the turmeric solution here.
Turmeric solution, and when we are adding the soap solution.
Yes, all right, very interesting.
One more thing that we actually prepared, that is how the curcumin is changing to curcuminoid and how the reverse reaction happened, how the reversible change is going on.
So I didn't know there is a reversible change.
Yes, because as I told you, this is an organic substance and they give a slow reaction. And that have a reversible change.
Slow reactions are reversible in nature.
I didn't know this. All right. So can we please see that? You can actually show that.
Yeah, when we have this curcumin, when we add more soap solution or when we keep on washing again and again.
Again and again.
Yes, then what happened? This curcuminoid again changed back to curcumin.
See, the stain is now turning slightly yellow.
Yes, you can see
that. The edges where it is drying up, is it?
Yes, where it is drying up.
All right.
Because it is changing back to curcumin.
All right, the fly also wants to learn. We have a student here. Yes. All right. Wow, can we see that?
Ma'am, we need to dry it up.
Let's see it here, where it has already dried.
If I put detergent here, it will turn yellow again. Oh, it will turn red.
How fascinating.
Yellow is disappearing.
It will take, as you are saying, it's a slow reaction. Yes. It will take some time. I see.
But the change is visible. You can see
because it has dried up already. Now we have prepared it like 5-10 minutes before.
So it has dried up and it is turning back to khaki.
Ah, I can see this is turning yellow.
Yes.
Amazing. I didn't know this at all. That's really amazing. All right.
Here on cloth piece also you can see that how the yellow color is coming.
Oh, alright. So this is paper, these round one pieces are
filter paper
and this is the
piece of
cloth material on which you have done this and this is going to then?
It will take time. But it is faster.
Alright.
I see.
Mm-hmm. And then if we wash it off, what if after this we wash it off then that process will stop?
First it will change back to the color of curcumin and later on it will dry up, and when it will in the presence of sunlight, maybe the light that is actually due to the wear and tear on the surface of the cloth, the color is actually disappear.
Alright. So this color that we get, this could be this kind of a dark color or this kind of a color, or it could be even lighter pink.
Depending on the dilution, and depends
on how much was there, how much amount the curry or whatever it was contained, the curcumin part of it,
concentration. As well as concentration of soap that we are using, both detergent, they both will decide.
That decides the color, how light it is or how dark it is, sometimes it is pink and sometimes it is red. Maybe it is because of a combination of the other spices and oil and all that we have put. Mm-hmm. So for that, nobody I think will analyze that much, and it's not even needed to exactly pinpoint why this color could be different. Yes.
Pink,
but we can see.
Pink,
yes.
Brown, red, brown.
All right. Yeah,
we are having three in the same.
So I wonder what chemical reaction is actually taking place. You know the formula for curcumin, and on that we have the basic formula for detergent.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
So then is there a chemical action that happens over there, which is actually, we can see the process here.
Yeah.
We don't yet know the reason why this is happening. This is a commonly seen occurrence. We need to know the chemical reaction. That is what I wanted to know.
Actually, there is a isomers, ketone and enol form. So once we see that in the, we have already the reaction which shows what happened. The ketone form and the enol form, they both exist in a equilibrium to each other.
Yes.
That is a reversible change.
You have shown
here. You can see here.
Alright, I'll turn that side. Yes, I'll turn that side.
How the curcumin is carrying the ketone form, the first one.
These are
the two double bonds. That's why it is considered in the keto-enol tautomerism.
This is keto form and this is enol form. Enol means a double bond with an alcoholic.
E and ol. So it is enol
attached to an alcoholic.
Yes. Alright.
This is the formula for detergent. And when curcumin reacts with detergent, the negative charge that is present on oxygen extracts this hydrogen. This hydrogen goes with this oxygen, which is formed. Double bond shifts, and we are left with just one hydrogen.
So maybe you could explain what is this double bond and what happens actually, and why is it that you are showing some cases there is this one line and at some cases one line where here you have one line.
Actually, these are the two benzene rings, and benzene rings have alternate single double bonds.
This is benzene ring
that is carrying alternate maybe you have studied that there is a ring inside given by Kekulé.
There are two H.
Different lines in this part.
So there are two H.
Earlier we have two H here,
two
now
H.
we have just one.
One. And one of them combines with this oxygen here.
Yeah.
O is oxygen.
Yeah, and my double bond has shifted downwards. This bond will break. It will shift upwards. This will shift with oxygen and we get this.
So there is a change within the structure.
Yes.
There is a change within inside the structure.
Yes. That's why we call it keto form and we are calling it enol form.
Can you please explain again what is the keto form?
And keto form is when we have carbon attached to a double bond O. And this is enol form when we have carbon attached to a double bond along with one alcohol linker.
Alright.
Yes. This is the change in the structure that we need.
We can see here the reversible equilibrium sign. Yeah. That is, they both are existing.
So from that step, then we come to this step.
Yes.
So and this then is the
this red colored compound changes back to again yellow because of this reversible.
How does the detergent come in?
And detergent is initiating this reaction. It is extracting this hydrogen.
Oh, so it's the detergent which enables this breaking bond.
That's it.
As it has a tendency to donate proton, and H is going in the form
base,
of H plus.
It is a base, so it can extract hydrogen.
Oh, okay, alright.
Acid-base reaction.
And it remains the same.
And because this is hydrophobic part, it will not interact with water, so it will remain same.
That's why there's so much soapy solution which we have to wash out then.
Yeah.
That remains some formation of cluster structure, so that is the formula for
detergent and ion in water.
So here what is happening is only that this
this bond,
there is some change in the detergent also, and there is a break in bond here.
The structure will be like this.
Okay. I don't think that will be visible.
Use the
shears and
you
visible.
Okay.
Oh, if you
No, that's
quite visible.
Visible, yes.
So this bond is polar in nature.
Polar in nature?
Yeah. Because we have opposite charges, na?
What?
When we have opposite charges, the bond becomes polar in nature. So it will break and it will dissociate into its own.
So, when this breaks, this is also just breaking of a bond.
In water?
Yeah, ionizes. In water, it ionizes.
It means
they are changing. This is a charged ion. In aqueous medium, it is a mobile phase. So, and it ionizes actually because of the SO4 minus and Na plus.
And this is not reversible. This will remain like this.
Yeah, because this is an ionic bond, ionic
character. That part is reversible.
So then here the detergent loses its power of ionizing and cleaning up, is it? The cleansing action also becomes weak.
After
this has happened?
Yes.
So then we can't use it anymore, or it will be, at least it will be less effective. Maybe there are other ingredients in the detergent and those might still be active. But this is the main part and that's why we have to throw it out.
It has to be removed away with water.
Now the entire process is crystal clear to me. I hope to the viewers also. So now we get to this part that what happens, why this color changes and it becomes from yellow to red.
Yes.
Alright, but now even then the red stain is still there and that will go only when we put it out in the sun.
Yes.
Right? We put it out in the sun and that should be also a nice sunny day, the better.
Yes.
Even if it is not, even then it does go, eventually it goes. So we put it out in the sun and then that pink color also evaporates.
Yeah.
So what is happening there?
And that part, I suppose, is physics one.
That is physics?
That is physics.
Yeah.
Oh, the chemistry is the reaction.
Yeah.
Till the reaction when part. It is evaporating, there is no chemistry that is going to happen.
That is basically a physics part.
So who will explain the physics part?
We'll call our physics
teacher. Will call the physics teacher?
Yeah.
And this question of what is actually happening, why it turns pink and why it evaporates, this had been, you know, perplexing me for a very long time. I wanted to know what is exactly the scientific process that is going on inside. And believe me, I have asked so many experts who are postgraduates in chemistry, who are specialized in organic chemistry. This is organic chemistry?
Yes.
So who have these specializations, who are teaching at different levels, who are teaching, who are researching, who have PhDs, can you beat it? And they are teaching at all levels, school level, college level, university level. They are in various established, recognized positions, and I did not get the correct, complete answer from anyone. Most people said we just don't know. The most common answer that I got is that, oh, this is a neutralization, you know, and this is, that's why it becomes pink, and the pink is an indicator that there is a change from acid to base. So it's just an indicator, and that's why we are appearing this as pink. But that was not the answer that I was looking for. And for that, let me tell you that Saloni here was one of the persons who was able to give me the correct answer. And then Tejasvi here had to pitch in. I did get some good advice from other experts, which I'll maybe paste here, that this is the parts that some others also contributed.